base of Fort Point, underneath Golden Gate Bridge.
Really quite the structure. All brick and granite construction. It's a lot of detail. Up near the top, interesting long sections of machine-cut granite. Some thin red brick. And a large section of additional machine-cut granite on top. Down to a different shade of brick with all the arched windows, and every individual opening has this white granite sill as well. Locked up entrances, you can see that's been closed up. Another one. So really the only entrance above ground. So here we have heavily decomposed granite archway, large door. Granite pedestal. So meticulous machine cut inside corner, fantastic. With granite sill to the opening of the door. So this is extreme masonry. These beveled edges going around the corner. All the way to the top of the building. Extremely hard. It's amongst the hardest stones in the world is granite. And have a look at the craftsmanship of this brickwork. Survived all the major earthquakes of the Bay Area. Just flawless. Now these doors are worthy of investigation. All on its own. They go around this side of the building. They have openings on multiple floors. Thank you.
quite a spectacular building, a lot of history, meeting some tourists and looking around, but we're going to look at the seawall. This is an amazing feature of this area, and they are interlocking, so we're going to look at it. So this area here is pretty weathered, but you can see the repeating pattern. So there's three separated, two separated, and now we got the long run. So this run extends all the way down, turns the corner, and continues. And you can see the repeating pattern on the bricks. These are big granite bricks. Each one continues for a very long ways. You get a look at it. So really spectacular. But there's more to the story, always. So we see this wall is about 5 feet wide on the top. And this continues around the corner and around the entire perimeter of Fort Point and continues up the coast. And it has some actual bevel-shaped cutting into it, possibly to protect against the water. But we're going to go down in here and look at more and tell you a lot more. It's pretty low tide, a little slippery. So here's your look at the face of this amazing granite wall. Look at these precision cuts. Have a look. But again, there's always more to the story. So I'm down below grade of the top of the seawall, and I'm standing on top of the boulders, which have all been added. So before the addition of the boulders, this entire running wall is multiple courses tall, and it has a repeating pattern. And there's also some metal in there. So we see this metal. I don't know what that green is. Down here, some kind of really heavy rusting or something else. No idea. But the key point is, this is a massive wall made out of massive granite sections. This one here in front of me, it's probably 8 feet long. And then the middle section, foot and a half, another 8-footer, and it just runs and runs. I believe the bottom of the wall that I've seen in the oldest photos, when the boulders are missing and the foundation is not visible because it's always below sea level, but it appeared to be 40 or 50 feet, and there may have been a dozen visible courses. But this place is amazing. And that's all machined granite. We're here at Fort Point, and I've met a man from France, Jerome.
Yes.
And he has a story about the wall and what he noticed in the movie Vertigo.
Vertigo.
What can you tell me?
From Alfred Hitchcock. And you have James Stewart, and I don't remember the girl. She's very famous. In the movie,
right,
and she jumped into the water from here, and Hitchcock had the camera there, and John Stewart sees a woman, and he comes to save her,
right,
but there was no rocks here because it's impossible to jump, so it's the rocks.
How long was the fall? With the rocks gone?
I don't know.
Right. 50 feet? maybe taller than the building.
But you have to see the movie.
You know
the movie?
I do.
Oh,
thank you for the tip. Thank you very much.
So meeting some interesting people.
Curiouser and curiouser. So I'd heard that there might be lead between the joints, the megalithic seawall. And I'm down here examining what's between the joints, and it is metal. I don't think it's lead. It's really hard steel. Further down you go, there's metal. There is metal between all of it.
Wait, don't move.
More metal. Metal.
Like
wrapping up my first trip really at Fort Point and having a really good look. You can come back here for days and days in the surrounding area. There's just tremendous things to see, but let's walk the seawall. See the repeating pattern? 3, 2, 3, 2. And here we have a corner. We've got just the right angle necessary to accommodate the wall as it continues. Huge, huge pieces of granite. And I just found out they are separated by metal.